Good morning, friends. Now I will tell you how can we diagnose mental problems, behavioral problems in children very early. So these things, mental and behavioral problems of children, these are like egg and chicken. We don't know who has come first, whether first egg has come or first chicken has come. Likewise, we are not sure whether it is genetic or whether it is environmental. Everything has a role to play, whatever it is. Right before pregnancy, you heard me right? Right before pregnancy, when the parents, father and mother, unite to give rise to baby, the sperm of the father, the quality of the sperm, the quality of the egg, both determine the behavior of the child. For example, if the father is having depression, baby can have it. Behavioral problems, either aggression or depression or any other behavior problems, are increased in these such children. If the father is having obesity, baby is at high risk of cancer. That is during the production of sperm I am taking. Same applies to mother. Mother is taking a lot of sugar, then baby can have depression as well as bronchial asthma. Behavior of these parents, aggressiveness of these parents, determine the change in epigenetic modification. It is called epigenetic modification, change in genetics. It means a person can change his genetic structure by changing certain habits and behavior and transmit these things to the genes of their offsprings. Second thing, while pregnancy, if there is mineral or vitamin deficiency, they are not taking proper diet. Excess of certain diet and lack of certain minerals, it can lead to autism, attention deficit disorders, abnormal behavior, etc. Improper growth of the baby, like tension, this can lead to mothers having small babies, excess stress in the mother. The small babies, they become small babies. Some amount of their brain will be preserved, but there will be lot of stress on the liver and stomach tissues. And liver is a detoxificant, and when liver is not at full maturity, they can have problem with jaundice, which can lead to behavioral problems if it is at a very high level and not properly treated. They can lead to accumulation of toxins in the body because of a weak liver. That can also lead to problems. They have less transmission of immunoglobulins from mother to baby, causing recurrent infection, and recurrent infections can lead to behavioral problems. And stressful mothers produce lesser milk, and then can also lead to other problems. Now, during delivery, if there is some problems, which is the only time from doctors really help the baby out, rest of the time it is when baby is with parents. So during that time, if there is problem, baby can have behavioral problems. Main thing, still if there is something during these things, we can modify it if we find these things very early. That is, for example, if the baby is not having a meaningful eye contact response to mother's words or face, baby is not having that meaningful social smile, not simply smiling in reciprocation to mother, recognition of mother face. It's an early symptom that baby is not interested in human face or communication, earliest sign of autism. Another thing is baby is not getting proper sleep. If the baby is not getting proper sleep and baby is having abnormal breathing movements, persistently baby is having lot of snoring, nose is not properly open, very irritable, and baby is having this behavioral, this is abnormal movements during breathing, too much every time, not able to breathe because of nose block, recurrent episodes of improper, lack of quality of sleep. These things can eventually lead to aggressiveness, irritability, and behavioral problems. Another thing is baby is having slow development, like neck holding, these are becoming slow, flattening of head. These can impair the IQ and lead to behavioral problems. To prevent flattening, you need to keep this baby in sunlight and use a mustard pillow and give some time for playing over the stomach while the baby is awake, so that baby head becomes round in shape. So these things, if you take care of, we are talking about early infancy, and proper diet for IQ, like lot of seeds, lot of DHA, omega 3 fatty acids, these are available in seeds and panjiri. When these things are there, it can be very helpful in improving the behavior of the child. Keep watching Dr. K. Babu channel. Take care. Have a good day.